Okay, cut to later in your early life in New York City, he continues, and the monochrome has deepened into colour. But the colours of the night, of course. And now she's looking sideways, across the matchless allure of the Manhattan cityscape after sunset, from just above the skyscraper's tops. The three or four most iconic structures are all where they should be, as if her framing them like this were easy, and there's a subtle perfection of lighting. Above the myriad illuminated windows, in buildings whose shapes will remain discernible for only another half minute in this sinking dusk, there's a soft-edged band of orange, merging flawlessly into yellow right above it, merging further through nameless subtleties into pink, at last hitting the upper frame as a cool, dim lilac. All these being darker and tinged with russet at the left end of the image. Here, 30 floors above 53rd and Lexington, she turns to the left where the east grows dimmer, taking in the expanse of Queens and Brooklyn in the dusk. Above the soft flicker of the very furthest beds of lights, an aeroplane hangs still, sinks through a brown glow down into purple, and disappears behind the dark horizon. A charcoal layer presses down, far beneath high clouds, underlit from low sun setting in the west behind her head. One lone skyscraper stands on the East River's other bank, across from her, topped by scarlet beacons like a pair of mineral eyes.